Joining us live with more is the Assistant Treasurer and Financial Services Minister, Stephen Jones. Appreciate your time, Minister. Thank you. I'm going to get to that proposal in a minute, but first I was going to get your reaction to the news we've just broken here on Sky News. George Negus, the television news legend, has died after suffering from Alzheimer's. He really was one of a kind, feared by plenty of politicians like yourself over his career.
Look, he was a giant of journalism and a giant of news. I grew up watching George Negus broadcasting throughout from around the world and through across Australia. A great loss to journalism, and I'm sure all of his colleagues in the many networks that he worked with over the years will be mourning his passing. Love to his family and friends.
Yes, he will be missed, a real giant of the industry. Let's have a look at this surcharges proposal. Just give us a sense of how much Australians are spending on those sorts of surcharges and why you're making this move now.
Look, we're making it in response to very justified consumer concerns that they've been forced out of using cash because it's harder to get your hands on and a lot more places aren't using it. Debit cards, tap and go are the new form of cash, and yet they find themselves hit with surcharges, unreasonable surcharges, for making the most minor purchases. We've had enough. We want to ensure that both consumers and small businesses get a fair go here. So we've sent a very clear message to the payments industry that this is things have got to change, that consumers and small businesses have got to get a fair go. And we've signalled with plenty of notice that if this isn't sorted, a ban will be in place by 2026.
And so can you reassure those small businesses that they won't be the ones left bearing the cost of those surcharges?
Absolutely, and that's why we're going through a very deliberative process. The Reserve Bank will be conducting its review over the next few months with a report by the end of the year, outcomes of that early next year. Nothing in any of this is stopping the banks, the payment systems providers and others from moving ahead of that and saying, we've listened to business, we've listened to consumers, and we're going to drop the surcharges. No reason why consumers should be being slugged. These new blended fees, which are slugging consumers for accessing their own money, they're rightfully concerned. But we're going to do this in a way that ensures that small businesses aren't slugged as a result of it.
Well, I'm sure that consumers will be happy to hear about that. Anything, as you know, helping people with the cost of living at the moment is pretty popular. Is it a bad look on that issue to be talking a lot about how tough it is for Australians, how much the cost of living is biting, particularly when it comes to the housing sector, but then to have the Prime Minister, Anthony Albanese, buying a $4.3 million house with his fiancée, do the optics of that worry you ahead of an election?
Look, I wish Jodie and the Prime Minister all the very best. They're entitled, like every other Australian is, to ensure that they've got a place, a roof over their heads. We're doing everything we can and a lot more to come in the area of housing to ensure that Australians can put a roof over our head. I note today that the Shadow Housing Minister said he won't be held to any standard or he won't be held to account for his housing plan. We've got a big, bold, ambitious agenda to build more homes, to help more Australians into more homes, and we're not going to be distracted by, frankly, what are, you know, silly issues that have got no bearing on the task at hand, and that is to ensure more people building more homes for more Australians to have a roof over their head.
Stephen Jones, appreciate you making the time. Thank you.
Good to be with you.